Sevilla, the city which 500 years ago transformed a small, hopeful dream into thrilling reality. The city which 5 centuries ago, based on only wistful, luminous expectation, opened the horizons of mankind to a new world. But a bird's eye view of Sevilla is not enough. Its meaning will not be found by looking at monuments, winding streets, or palaces. Sevilla is its people, the subtle archers of whom García Lorca spoke. Those archers who between rhythmic hands, verses and elegance, pierce you with the poisoned chant of Sevilla. Every spring, Sevilla perfumes its streets with incense, orange blossoms and rosemary in order to celebrate the passion and resurrection of Christ and to honor the suffering of his mother. For the people of Sevilla, Holy Week is the triumph of life over death, of eternity over mortality. Whether they worship the Macarena Virgin or the power of Christ, the Virgin of Hope, the Virgin of Triana, or the Christ of peaceful death, the people of Sevilla, all of them, share the joyful sadness which invades the streets with religious fervor before the majestic passing of their venerated images. A bit later in the spring, there is the splendor of the most joyful and dynamic celebration. La Feria, the April Festival. Starting in the middle of the 19th century as a livestock fair, the joyfulness, the exuberant vitality, the savoir-faire, the knowing how to enjoy the moment, which the people of Sevilla excel in, converted a commercial fair into a festival of friendship. How can I explain in a few words about this wonderful, electrifying flood of joy which is crystallized in the graceful waving of young girls' hands who, dressed in ruffles, dance to the rhythm of a guitar? How can I tell you of the flutter of one's heart at nightfall when entering the city of canvas and light, of lanterns and sherry glasses filled with gold? The festival is one and a thousand at the same time, It is variable and different according to the light which illuminates it, and each of its facets bewitches us in a special way. The morning festival with horseback riding, the aperitif and sunshine. The evening festival, the festival at dawn. In effect, the April festival has many faces, but the key, as Díaz-Cañabate say, to understanding its mystery, it's to be in love, or its equal, to have a dream. So, I've told you, search carefully. In Sevilla, there is always more. No other city in the whole world, not even Paris or Rome, has inspired as many composers and librettists as Sevilla. Among them are, for example, Beethoven, Rossini, Bizet, Verdi, not to mention Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, whose two major works, Nozze di Figaro and Don Giovanni, take place in Sevilla. Mozart's Don Giovanni is based on the Don Juan character by Zorrilla, but he seems to be more influenced by the Italian Casanova with his fascinating appearance, his noble elegance, his irresponsible behavior, his quarrelsome attitude, and his art of seduction. But some traits are present in both Don Giovanni and Don Juan: pride, charm, virility, and an exuberant joy of living.
Fincan al vino, calda la testa, una gran festa va a preparar. Se trovi in piazza qualche ragazza, e con cor quella cerca menar. E con cor quella cerca menar, cerca menar, cerca menar. Senta alcun ordine, la danza sia, che il minuetto, chi la follia, chi la remana, quale ballar. Il minuetto, pare ballar, chi la follia, pare ballar, chi la remana, pare ballar. Egli frattanto dall'altro canto, con questi quella va amoreggiar, va amoreggiar, va amoreggiar. Alla mia lista, domani mattina, una decina devi aumentar. Alla mia lista, una decina devi aumentar. Se trovi in piazza qualche ragazza, ecco quella cerca menar. Alla mia lista, domani mattina, una decina devi aumentar. Senza alcun ordine, la fantasia, chi il minuetto, chi la follia, chi la levana, quale gallar. Alla mia lista, domani mattina, una decina devi aumentar, una decina devi aumentar, una decina devi aumentar, devi aumentar, devi aumentar, devi, devi aumentar.
This aria was filmed in the Alcázar with its beautiful gardens and which is the oldest royal palace in Europe. You also saw me at the tower called La Giralda, which is the symbol of Sevilla. Here I stand at the Patio de Banderas, Patio de Flags, in Santa Cruz. And Santa Cruz is a part of the town which cannot be described. Santa Cruz is a part of the city which smells of flowers, hides stolen kisses, and closes gates upon passionate whispers. Santa Cruz is a section of the city which has the heavy perfume of jasmine, the fire of bougainville, and is lit by a large, beautiful mother-of-pearl moon. Santa Cruz is a place where someone who loves us seems always to be waiting. In the sleepy shade of a patio, behind the musical closing of a gate, through the filigree of a balcony we can find today, as though suspended in time, Rosina waiting for Count Almaviva, or Elvira wandering through walls of ivy and grapevines in search of Don Juan. Santa Cruz Square, a closed carnation. Doña Elvira Square, proud and beautiful. Callejón del Agua, the alleyway of water. A wound, deep and cured with lime, according to the verse of Fernando Villalón. The streets named Pimienta, pepper. Maison del Moro, Tavern of the Moor, the street of glory, the street of life. You see, Santa Cruz is a place which cannot be described. One must live it slowly, linger through it without haste, and then dream of it forever. Here in Santa Cruz, I will perform the duet from The Barber of Seville. I decided to sing the part of Figaro, which is the baritone. It was very difficult for us to find a light tenor for the part of Almaviva. But finally, A good friend of mine did it as a personal favor. I will not mention his name, but you might recognize him.
All'idea di quel metallo portentoso mi possente un vulcano la mia mente già comincia a diventar sì all'idea di quel metallo un vulcano la mia mente incomincia a diventar sì sì all'idea di quel metallo un vulcano la mia mente incomincia a diventar a diventar a diventar un vulcano incomincia a diventar. Vediam di quel metallo. Qualche effetto sorprendente del vulcano della tua mente. Qualche mostro singolar. Sì, della tua mente. Qualche mostro singolar. Sì, sì. Del vulcano della tua mente qualche mostro singolar, sì, singolar, sì, singolar, qualche mostro singolar. Voi dovreste travestirvi.
Da soldato,
sì signore,
da soldato,
e che si fa, che si fa, che si fa?
Oggi arriva un reggimento,
sì,
e mio amico il colonnello, e mio amico il colonnello, e poi,
aspetto, nell'alloggio col biglietto, quella porta s'aprirà,
e che ne dite?
Non vi par, non l'ho trovata.
Che invenzione,
che invenzione,
che invenzione, che invenzione,
prelibata.
Che invenzione, prelibata,
bella, bella, bella,
bella, in verità.
Sì, sì,
che invenzione, prelibata,
bella, 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 bella,
bella, bella,
in verità.
Il meglio mi scordavo, dimmi un po'. tua bottega per trovarti. Dove sta la bottega? Non si sbaglia, guardi bene, eccola là! Numero 15, a mano manca, 4 gradini, facciata bianca, 5 parrucche nella vetrina, sopra un cartello, pomata fina, posta in azzurro, alla moderna, pepe insegna, una lanterna, la senza fallo, mi troverà, 5 parrucche nella vetrina, sopra un cartello, pomata fina, posta in azzurro, alla moderna, pepe insegna, una lanterna, la senza fallo, la senza fallo, la senza fallo mi troverà. 5 parrucche, una lanterna, la senza fallo mi troverà. Ho ben capito, arriva da presto, tu guarda bene, io penso al resto. Ditemi Fido, colà l'attendo, mio caro Figaro.
Intendo, intendo.
Porterò me
con la borsa piena.
Sì, quel che vuoi, ma il resto poi.
Oh, non si dubiti che bene andrà, e bene, bene, bene andrà.
A che l'amore la fiamma io sento, un già di giubilo e riconsento. D'ardor insolito questa l'accende, e di me stesso maggior mi fa.
Delle monete in son già
sento, che l'amore la fiamma sento.
Già viene l'or,
già
eccolo, già viene l'argento, già viene l'argento.
Ecco,
ecco, la tasca scende, eccolo qua.
Ecco, propizia, che in sé mi sente, l'ardor insolito, questa alma accende, e di me stesso maggior mi fa, 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 sì sì, maggior mi fa.
Without doubt, the opera which stands out in using Sevilla as the setting is Georges Bizet's Carmen. And here we are in front of the famous tobacco factory where it all started. This building looks more like a king's palace than a factory, and indeed, it is the third largest in Spain after the Escorial and the Royal Palace in Madrid. Today, this is the University of Sevilla. Up to 12,000 people worked here in those days, and among them, Carmen, this passionate, fascinating, bewitching creature who beneath the dark glance of her eyes hides a rebellious, temperamental bird who wants its freedom at any price. Here, Don José first saw Carmen. Perhaps he was on duty in one of these little guardhouses when she came out with her friends on a break, flirting, laughing, and enjoying life here under the trees. As you know, Don José fell in love, but this resulted in his imprisonment. After a month in prison, he finds Carmen again. In one of the most beautiful, tender romances of any opera, he confesses to her that not one day had passed without dreaming of her, and that the flower which she tossed to him gave him the strength, the support, and the will to live and to reach her again.
Jeter
d'homme prisonnier.
Andalusia, as we know it today, like all of Spain, is the product or melting pot of successive waves of different people who settled here. Phoenician merchants, Greek adventurers, civilized Romans, cultured and refined Arabs who invaded the peninsula in the year 711, converted Andalusia into the cultural center of the world at that time. The Arabs in Cordoba, the Kingdom of Granada, the Kingdom of Sevilla. A century later, King Ferdinand encircled Sevilla like a bride after a tough battle, and thanks to the Virgin of the Kings, since then the patron saint of the city, he conquered it and established his court there. The Christian kings continued their reconquest from there, which is why Andalusia is scattered with castles and fortresses like the one where we filmed the aria from Forza El Destino, which we did in Almodóvar del Río, despite the fact that this particular aria takes place in Italy, where Don Álvaro is fighting in exile. In his loneliness, he dreams only of returning to Leonora and Sevilla.
Love you.
vita inferno all'infelice. Invano morte desio.
Soccorrimi, Leonora.
Through the centuries, many cultures have left their tracks in and around Seville and have also shaped the Andalusian mentality. Here we are in Italica, a few kilometers from Sevilla, at the ruins of the first Roman city built in Andalusia after the Second Punic War. Here, on this land of loneliness and hilly gloom, a song by Rodrigo Caro, beneath the wise silver sadness of the olive trees, beneath the burning song which scorches the earth, we have chosen this unique setting for the famous Florestan aria from Beethoven's magnificent opera, Fidelio, which also took place here in Sevilla. Florestan is kept in prison without knowing the reason, maybe because he simply told the truth, a fate which is unfortunately shared by people even today in too many places. While Beethoven in Vienna composed his Freiheit's drama, Fidelio, here in Spain, another great artist, the painter Francisco Goya, fought for the same principles of freedom and justice and against violence and totalitarianism with his weapons by creating the famous series of etchings entitled Los Desastres de la Guerra. We, in our film, brought together these two geniuses linked and inspired by the same ideals.
Thank you. Zu Freiheit, bis himmlischer Reich, der Spanish operas, and one is Fenella's El Gato Montes, The Wild Cat. The story is similar to Carmen, but the roles are reversed. The tenor is the bullfighter, and the baritone is an outlaw. Both fight for the love of the same woman, Soledad. Here we see the bullfighter at an important moment, when he prays in the chapel of the bull ring before the fight. It is a tense, vibrant moment of irrepressible anxiety in which the soul of the bullfighter asks help from his most faithful protector, the Virgin Mary. Here in the chapel of the Maestranza, we see the image of the Virgin and the bullfighter's prayer, which is recited by all of them before going into the ring. It is an important moment of reflection. We singers know of the risk before an audience, but we only risk our fame. They risk their lives.
Me llamabas Rafaelillo.
Sí, mujer, pa' que me hagan la corbata. Que yo no me la sé hacer.
¡Oso que pillo! ¡Vaya un tronero! Y pues saberse quién te la hace cuando estás fuera.
No falta un arma, caritativa.
¡Vaya por Dios! Pues esa armita voy a ser yo.
¡Qué graciosa, mi gitana! ¡Qué preciosa!
Yo entendiendo que a mi vida ya no más es fortanà.
Solea,
era valigio,
di pitana,
era valigio,
tuia, tuia, sì.
Stand before the maestranza bull ring, which in an atmosphere of majesty, composure, and harmony awaits for men who will raise danger to the category of art. And here, at this mythical place of death, we will perform the finale from Bizet's opera Carmen, which my friend Jean-Pierre Ponel staged inside the arena.
Yeah! te sauver, toi que j'adore.
Donnez